Gazpacho, gazpacho.
Gazpacho is very easy, quick. It's a cold soup, and my kids love it. Of course, it's a Spanish dish, but we do a lot of gazpacho in France. We take off the green part here, red bell pepper. As you can see, most of the vegetables are raw. It needs still a lot of technique and the best quality of ingredients. You know, that's the secret of this recipe. Cut the cucumber. I'm taking off the seed because it's better for your digestion. You don't want to have in any food you're doing, the germ is not good. If you don't have a spring onions, you always can use regular onions. So I'm going to peel it, cut it like this. Little dice is good. And now I'm going to show you how to peel the tomato. You're going to put a little touch of salt in the boiling water and you're going to mark an X. We're going to put them in the boiling water for, I would say, 30 seconds. When you take the skin like this, start to peel, the tomato is ready. Up, ice water right away. If you don't boil the tomato, it's not possible to take off the skin. Boil? Boil. That's what to boil. Boil. I cannot say this thing. When I was doing my apprenticeship, I was peeling a lot of tomato because in the fancy restaurant in France, we don't serve the skin. So we peel all the tomato. And at that time, I don't know why, I was allergic to tomato. And it was just like, give me a rush everywhere in my hand. But I never complained. Like I was just like crazy, like rushing me, like my hand was red or whatever. I mean, it was insane. Now I don't have any more allergy. I don't know why. Les tomates sont épluchées. Voilà. Big piece like this, it's fine. Oh, it smells so good. So our mise en place is ready. I'm going to put everything in the blender. I'm going to add the little touch of extra virgin olive oil. Un petit peu de poivre blanc, white Sarawak pepper. Make sure it's sealed very well. Trust me, I see some mistakes like this in the kitchen where... Hop, hop. Oh, it don't work. Ah, here we go guys, the light. We're going to blend slowly, okay? So now I'm going to put a little touch of good Xerez vinegar. A little touch of mustard, strawberry. Why tomato with strawberry? Because it makes sense, it's red and red. When you add water, what's going to happen? The texture of the gazpacho is going to be more liquid, but also the water is going to dilute the whole gazpacho and change the flavor. You get it? Voilà. Look at this, guys. Look at the color. I mean, it's just beautiful. Look at the texture. I'm very happy with that now, very happy. So with that, I'm going to add a little garnish with that to make a little bit more French, a little less Spanish. I'm going to put my cream in my cold bowl by hand, like the old days. So I'm just going to whip my cream like this. I'm going to go faster a little bit. Put a little bit of salt, a petit peu de white pepper. Mix well again. Là. Comme on dit, change pas de bien, change pas de main, ça vient. Nobody understands what I say, thank God. I'm going to emulsify one more time my gazpacho. Look at this, guys, look at this. Not pretty? Make your gazpacho, leave it in the fridge for 1 hour, and serve it after. Put on my bowl here. Voilà. Big spoon of whipped cream here like this. Then I'm going to put a little bit of piment in this pellet. It's spicy, but a little sweet. Very good quality of extra virgin olive oil. A little bit. And then for finish, today I have Thai basil, but you can use regular basil, purple basil, whatever you want. And now, that's the best time, it's to test. So voilà, we have our gazpacho of tomato, whipped cream, and piment des spilettes. C'est bon.